if I feel the emotion, say at a moment of fear, and I allow myself to feel that and explore it, but in by doing so, it prevents me from moving forward with what I was actually doing at that moment.
Yep.
How do I manage that?
Right. So there's a philosophy: feel the fear and do it anyway, sort of thing.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yep. And then there's a philosophy of, all right, let's get to our fear. There's something that we're fearing. What is it? What are we afraid of? So right at the moment, we're feeling fear. Let's say, I'm afraid to speak up in a public setting. How many of you have that fear? Quite a few. All right. So you should be able to relate to this feeling, right? What's the feeling underneath the fear? What's going to happen when you speak up in a public setting?
People will judge me.
I'll be judged.
Rejection.
I won't be believed.
You said it wrong.
Children shall be seen and not heard.
Wrong. Yeah. Need to be silent.
Rejection.
Yeah.
Rejection. Can you see? And all we're doing with this fear is we're saying this by staying in a state of fear. We're actually saying, I'm so afraid that I can't feel that emotion. In other words, I don't want to feel that emotion. Right. So when I'm in a state of fear, the first thing I need to do is ask myself, why do I feel afraid? And I might say, oh, there's lots of women in the audience and two of them I find attractive. That could be happening. Right? Now, that doesn't mean you're all not attractive, ladies. It's just, this is a feeling somebody could have. Myself, I find my soulmate very attractive. So I could feel that, and then I think, oh no, they're going to feel certain things about me.
Mm.
So I could identify that particular emotion then. Right? So what am I afraid of feeling? I'm afraid of feeling women that I am attracted to rejecting me. And I don't want to feel that emotion, so I get into a state of fear. Right? Allow